Today we are going to do very interesting program, lecture coming with music together. So all over the program, lecture, the lesson, what we call it, you will have music playing, my composition, to songs of Shabbos, as we mentioned, that is a great thing to our rabbis to sing a lot of songs all over the three meals of Shabbos. There are special songs for the evening of Shabbos, for the morning, for the third meal, afternoon, and the songs themselves, the words, also are fitting the evening, the morning. And this is what we are going to hear now, music which is for those three meals, as I will tell you exactly which one, for which, and then definitely explaining what is behind the letters of Shabbos, the words of Shabbos. This is a song which we sing in the Shabbos morning, which has the verse in the beginning, Baruch Kel Elyon Asher Natan Menucha L'Amo Yisrael. So Baruch Kel Elyon, blessed be God, it's a blank one, Asher Natan Menucha L'Amo Yisrael, to his people. And the continuation is that the man who keeps the Shabbos properly, guards the Shabbos, so it is like an offering to God, like he gives offering to God, which is definitely very significant and important. And then describing the preparation for Shabbos, dressing nicely, going to pray, singing to God, all of it in this wonderful song. The composition, the melody are composed, and the verse are from the Song of Shabbat. And it is sung by a group, Israeli group, which is called Gilgal, Akad Gilgal. Now this is already another song, my composition to the verse Kari Bon Olam, just I explain to you what it means, and this is played by my son Yaakov Baruch. And sang by him and myself.
Thank you.
Now the song is called Ya Ribon Olam Ve'Olmaya, sung normally in the eve of Shabbos, the first meal, and the verse are Ka Ribon Olam, Yud Kei, God is the owner, the master of the world, of the many worlds of Zohar, as we said, few worlds, action, creation, creation, formation, emanation. And the letter Yud Kei, Ka Ribon Olam, indicates, according to our rabbis, God created this world with the letter Hey, we mentioned it in the previous lectures, and the word to come with the letter Yud. These are the two letters, the first letters of God, Yud and Kei. So Yud is the word, the letter of the word to come. And the reason is written why? Because Yud is a small letter. Because not so many people will have the merit to have the word to come. Because for this you have to keep the Torah, to keep the Shabbos, to keep the loss of the Torah. This why, like the Yud, is a small letter indicating the word to come. Shabbos is part of the word to come. And A is the letter He, as is written in Genesis, Behei Braham, God created the word with the letter He. The letter Hey, the letter with which this world was created, Olam Hazeh. So we mentioned the beautiful idea in the shape of this letter. This letter, not like Yud, very small one, like a big one, combined of two letters in the Aleph Bet, which is the letter Daled. Daled. Daled have two lines on top, and the line which is on top, and then a line which is going down, indicating the four elements. Dalet, fourth letter of the alphabet, four elements. This is the basis of creation. There are two elements which are flying around, which is fire and air. This is a line on top, one of the Dalet. There is a line going down, indicating the two elements which are going down, which are earth and water. What makes the letter He? Additional one, the letter Yud. Yud represents spirituality, sparks of God, which keeps the word going, and also electromagnetic, magnetic, all these forces behind the elements which cause the word go to work. So this is a letter He, and this is a letter which God created this world. So we sing, thanking God, and saying, Ya Ribon Olam, God is the master of this world, the world to come, and many, many other words. So on Shabbos, we have, it's supposed to be three meals. Now those three meals, according to Kabbalah, are against Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, forefathers. And there are reasons explaining why and what's the connection. Even deep explanation, we'll go into it now. But the meal of the eve of Shabbos, where we sing this song, Ka Ribon Olam, is against Isaac, and then the morning one is against Abraham, while the third one is against Jacob. Now this idea of this connection to the Sabbath is indicated in the shape of the letters Shabbat. The The letter Shin in Hebrew represents the three forefathers according to Kabbalah. As the Shin is composed of three letters, three bunches, letter Yud, one side in the middle of the Zayin is the other side, Vav. Together you have three letters Zayin, Yud, Vav, which in Hebrew really indicates to three meanings. It means every letter has a meaning. The letter Zayin in Hebrew represents weapon. The letter Yud represents wisdom, as we know so many times, Yud Kei. While the letter Vav represents straightness, beauty, harmony, straight line. So Abraham is connected with the letter Yud, source of wisdom, while Isaac in strength, and Jacob, Vav, harmony. So says the Kabbalah, the Zohar, on Sabbath, these three forefathers, their spirits, join Bat, the letter Shabbat is Shabbat, join the daughter of Israel on Shabbos, and this is really the importance of eating these three meals on Shabbos. Is a mitzvah to eat three of them, and definitely to accompany them with songs, as we said, because songs helps to elevate our neshama, our soul. It is interesting to point out that the numerical value of Shira and Zimra, we say that you are two expressions of Mizmor Shir, the Yom HaShabbat, and this really, Shira and Zimra represent, as if you remember, we explain that Shira and Zimra have to do with the Hebrew verse to shear, to prune, because we are shearing and pruning the physical shells from our being. So, very, very important to sing on Shabbos with the three meals. Now, this is a song welcoming the Shabbos. Shalom, shalom alechem. And we welcome the angels who come to visit us on Shabbos to see that we are preparing ourselves properly, then they bless us. And this way we welcome them, Shalom Alechem. So this is my melody. It's sang by me, my son, and played by my son, Yaakov, with the keyboard. This is the last part, definitely wishing the angels who are living, blessing and thanking them for what they blessed us for the Shabbos. Now this year, we are going now to finish this part and then we'll carry on.